Hi, everyone. Thank you for joining us today on AWS Online Tech Talk. I'm here to talk about designing DR strategy on Amazon RDS for SQL Server. And in this presentation, I'll be focusing on cross-region re-replica. With this, we want to show how deploying cross-region re-replica can simplify your overall DR strategy. My name is Sudhir Amin. I'm a database specialist and I primarily focus on SQL Server workloads. So let's go through the agenda. We'll start with the disaster recovery consideration. I will discuss the RPO and RTO that you can achieve with different DR options. And then I will talk about cross-region re-replica and share some of the best practices to implement and monitor the re-replica. I also have a demo at the end to show the implementation in my AWS account. As we know, for DR solution, RPO and RTO are the primary requirement. These requirements lets you decide which DR solution you choose. Business critical workloads that require low RPO and RTOs in minutes tends to use architecture, often referred as a hot standby or a warm standby site. This basically requires you to implement replication solution. And as you see on the top left-hand corner, the first column DR option, the first two options there, AWS DMS and cross-region re-replica, are the examples of replication solution to achieve in-minute RPO RTOs. The DMS does the logical replication at the table level using CDC, change data capture, and cross-region re-replica uses Microsoft high availability solution, always on availability group, to create a re-replica in a different region for disaster recovery. And it uses asynchronous replication. And as we move further, we'll talk about this in more detail. For customers who want to build cost-effective DR solution with RPOs in hours, they can consider building cold DR site. And they can simply move their SQL Server backup, which is native backups, or replicate the RDS snapshot that's part of the automated backup between the two regions to achieve the same DR goal. Now let's talk about cross-region re-replica in more detail. Cross-region re-replica was basically introduced to address two major use cases. First, to scale your application globally by deploying re-replica closest to your user location. This basically reduces read latency and improve the application performance, and therefore the end user experience. And another use case was to provide business continuity solution by promoting these re-replica to primary in the event of disaster recovery situation, such as a large-scale event that affects an entire AWS region. So let's see how it works. Before we talk about cross-region re-replica, let's understand what exactly is a re-replica. So let's start with an AWS region. Within this region, you have multiple availability zones, and you deploy a multi-AZ RDS instance. This basically creates an always-on replication and a cluster, as you see, primary and a secondary database instance using synchronous replication between them. Now you want to scale your architecture to meet your application demand, so you simply deploy a read replica. And this read replica will use a distributed availability group and creates an asynchronous replication between them. This read replica instance receives the data from the primary database instance and maintains the copy to offload the read queries and to reduce the load on the primary. To deploy cross-region re-replica, you simply choose another region and create a re-replica instead of same region, you use different region here. An important thing to remember, this requires you to have a functional networking between the two AWS region. And also, you will use a different endpoint in both regions. So read-write endpoint in the primary region, read-only endpoint in the disaster recovery region. The applications in the primary region will connect to this read endpoint, read-write endpoint, and the application in the DR region will connect to the read-only endpoint. And your application users will connect to the primary region, and in the event of a disaster, you simply promote your read replica into primary and steer your application traffic to that region. This is the simplified workflow for the disaster recovery event and how you respond to it. All right, so now it's time for the demo. So let's connect to the lab environment for a walkthrough of a cross-region re-replica architecture. So as you see, I'm connected to my AWS management console, and I'm connected right now to a primary region, North Virginia, and I have a few tabs open here. So I'll be navigating between them to show different region. So the second tab is connected to Ohio. This is where I will be deploying the re-replica. And this is my primary region. So let's go to the database instance So I've already provisioned a multi-AZ enabled RDS instance. So as you see, this is a SQL Server Enterprise Edition, and it's multi-AZ, and it's using always on. This is the prerequisite before you create the re-replica. Now let me click on it. So this primary database is connected to a primary VPC, and it's also connected to the managed AD for Windows authentication. Now, a few things I want to talk about as a prerequisite. The primary VPC in the North Virginia region also needs to be paired with the re-replica VPC in Ohio. For this, I'll switch to the VPC section and show you the prerequisite. Before you create the re-replica, you need to set up VPC pairing between the two regions. So let me filter this primary VPC and go to pairing connection. Here, I've created a pairing connection between the two VPC. As you see, North Virginia and Ohio are paired together with enabled routes. So these routes are important for network communication between the two regions. Similarly, I've also deployed a managed AD instance, and I'm using Enterprise Edition. This allows you to create multi-region Active Directory. Now here, I can connect to my RDS instance using both RDS endpoint as well as the listener endpoint. That's part of the always-on cluster. Now under replication, I've already provisioned a read replica in the Ohio region, as you see. What I will do is I'll show you how you can create a second read replica, and I'll just walk you through the wizard of creating read replica. To create read replica, I'll come back to the database, select my database instance, and under action, I will click on create read replica. All right, I'll start with the database identifier. So I'll name my database instance as DB replica 02. And under instance configuration, I will keep it as is. And this is one of the best practices. Try to keep the same instance class and storage class as your primary database so that it becomes easier for you to manage. And here under AWS region, I will choose the disaster recovery region. So in my case, I'm using Ohio. So let me pick that. Once I select Ohio, I can keep the storage configuration as default as a primary. And then under subnet group, I will choose my disaster recovery subnet group. And then under security group, I'll simply enable the security group for client access. And I will also use Windows authentication. So as I mentioned before, my Active Directory already exists because of the multi-region architecture. So I'll simply browse the directory, choose example.com, which is what I'm using in my case, and move forward. So the rest of the things, I'll keep it as default, and I'll simply go ahead and click on create read replica. So now it's going to create a secondary read replica. And while it's creating the secondary read replica, I would like to show how I'm monitoring the existing primary database. So I have a CloudWatch configured here. So let me navigate through the monitoring dashboard. So as you see, the primary database is being monitored using CloudWatch, and there's an active workload running in this instance. I'm using HammerDB to generate the workloads. The next thing I would like to show is how do you monitor the read replica? So for that, I'll use the navigation window here and scroll down to all metrics. And under Virginia, I will change this to Ohio. This is where my read replica exists. And I will choose RDS. And under RDS, I will pick per database metrics. And that will present me the search bar. So basically, I'll search for DB replica 01. This is what I pre-provisioned. And I can simply include that in my search list. And then that will give me access to all the metrics published for that database instance. So the most important metric to monitor the health of the read replica is the replication lag. So let me search this. Here is it. So replication lag is an important metric to monitor. And also remember, your read replica will receive the traffic from a primary database. So monitoring the network throughput is also critical. So I'll include them. And then you will also receive the data and write to the local disk. So I'll monitor the write performance. So I'll choose write throughput, latency, and IOPS. I prefer to see this in numbers instead of line chart. So I'll choose that number. For this demo, I'll simply go ahead and add this into my existing dashboard. For that, I'll click on the Action tab and then add it to the dashboard. This demo, I will simply use Replica 01 and then click on Add Dashboard. And in this way, I will monitor both primary database instance as well as the read replica in a single pane of glass. Now, the next thing I would like to show is connecting to the read replica and the database instance using SQL Management Studio. For that, I'll just switch to the SQL Management Studio window. So as you see, I'm connected now to the jump box, and I will switch to the SQL Server Management Studio. This is where I've already connected to the primary database instance. And let me connect to the replica instance as well. So here I will choose replica endpoint and click on connect. Now I've established connection in both database instance. So let's expand the database. And as you can see, the TPCC database is the database that I'm interested in protecting. This is my business critical workload as an example. So under this, I will have several tables. And one of the table that I'm interested in testing here is the RPO tracker. This is essentially empty right now. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a couple of scripts to insert some records into this table. And I will use another script where I will connect to the replica instance and try to read from it. So while it's running, I will also perform the cutover. So basically, I'll do a promotion of the read replica to see how quickly you can fail over between the two database instances. So my first objective is to show how the replication operates. So for this, as you see, currently there is no data here. So I'll simply start this script that is connected to the primary database instance. So as you see, this is going to run in loop every 2 seconds. And it starts populating the data. And I could see the same data in the replica instance. So let me scroll this, expand to the TPCC database section. And under table, I will simply check the records if it exists or not. OK, so this is exactly how the replication works. So I want to highlight a few things here. It's using the distributed availability group. And the good thing here is, as a DBA, you really don't have to manage the cluster or the replication instances. This is part of the service, and it's being provided as a feature for you. So as a DBA, you're only responsible to managing the performance, the health of the replication instance. Now I'll use the second database instance script. Here I'm connecting to the replica instance, and I'll just start this script as well. And this is essentially checking the database status, and it's going to read the records from there. And as you see, it's showing that this database is in read-only status at this point. So I'll keep both the instances in loop and on the screen. And while it is happening, I will simply go ahead and promote the read replica into primary. So for that, I have to connect to the Ohio region. So let's go to the Ohio region and go to database instance. This is where my two replica instances are. So I'll use the first one while the second is being created. And I'll choose the first read replica and click on action. And under action, I have the option to promote it. So I'll simply click on promote. When I click on promote, I'll also have the option to enable the backup. So I'll skip that for this demo, but you can keep it for your production cutover. So for now, I'll just simply go ahead and click on promote read replica. So when I do that, it basically breaks the relationship between the primary database instance and the secondary. And let's come back to it and monitor this. So this should take at least a few minutes. And as you notice here, the read replica is now promoted as a standalone database instance. And you can see the status showing as a read write. And this basically would be the time when you will actually switch over your application and point your application traffic to this instance. Now I would like to conclude the presentation and thank everyone for spending your time today with us. The links shown here will take you to the AWS product documentation, and it would be helpful to get started. Thank you once again. Have a great day.